How many solutions does the following system of linear equations have? And I have my system right over here. There's a couple of ways to think about it. One way is to think about them graphically and think about, well, are they the same line, in which case they would have an infinite number of solutions? Are they parallel, in which case they never intersect, you'd have no solutions? Or do they intersect exactly one place, in case you would have one solution? But instead, we're going to do this algebraically. So let's try to actually just solve the system and see what we get. So the first equation, I'm going to leave that unchanged. 5x minus 9y is equal to 16. Now this second equation right over here, let's say I want to cancel out the x terms. So let me multiply the second equation by negative 1. So I have a negative 5x that I can cancel out with the 5x. So if I multiply the second equation by negative 1, I'm going to have negative 5x plus 9y plus 9y is equal to negative 36. Negative 36. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to add the left sides of the equations and the right sides of the equations to get a new equation. So 5x minus 5x, well, that's going to be 0. Negative 9y plus 9y, well, that's going to be 0 again. I don't even have to write it. That's just going to be 0 on the left-hand side. And on the right-hand side, I'm going to have 16 minus 36, so I have negative 20. So now I'm left with the somewhat bizarre looking equation that says that 0 is equal to negative 20. Now one way you might say, well, how does this make any sense? And the way to think about it is, well, are there any x, y values for which 0 is going to be equal to negative 20? Well, no, 0 is never going to be equal to negative 20. And so it doesn't matter what x, y values, you can never find an x, y pair that's going to make 0 equal to negative 20. In fact, the x's and y's have disappeared from this equation. There's no way that this is going to be true. So we have no solutions. Now, if you were to plot each of these lines, you would see that they are parallel lines. And that's why they have the same slope, different y-intercepts, and that's why we have no solutions. They don't intersect. Let's do another one of these. This is fun. All right. How many solutions does the following system of linear equations have? So let's do the same thing. I'm going to keep the first equation the same. Negative 6x plus 4y is equal to 2. And the second equation, let me just see if I can cancel out the x term. So if I have a negative 6x, if I multiply this by 2, I'm going to have a positive 6x. So I can, let's see, I'm going to multiply this whole equation, both sides of it, by 2. So I'm going to have 6x, 3x times 2 is 6x, negative 2y times 2 is negative 4y, and that is going to be equal to negative 2. Now let's do the same thing. Let's add the left sides, and let's add the right sides. So negative 6x plus 6x, well, that's going to be 0. 4y minus 4y, that's 0. We just have a 0 on the left-hand side. Now on the right-hand side, we have 2 plus negative 2. Well, that's 0. So this is a little bit different. It still looks a little bit bizarre. 0 equals 0. Last time we had 0 is equal to, we had what, 0 is equal to negative 20. Now we have 0 equals 0. So one way to think about it is, even though the x's and y's are no longer in this equation, you can say, well, what x, y pairs is it going to be true for, that is going to make it true that 0 is equal to 0? Well, this is going to be true no matter what x and y are. In fact, x and y are not involved in this equation anymore. 0 is always going to be equal to 0. So this is going to have infinitely many solutions here. And that's because these are the same lines. They just look a little bit different algebraically, but if you scale one of them in the right way, in fact, if you just multiply both sides of this one, the second one, by negative 2, you're going to get the top one. And so they actually represent the exact same lines. You have an infinitely many solutions. All right. When trying to find the solution to the following system of linear equations, Yvonne takes several correct steps that lead to the equation negative 5 is equal to 20. How many solutions does the system of linear equations have? I don't even have to look at the system right over here. The fact that she got the statement that can never be true, negative 5 is never going to be equal to 20, tells us that she has no solutions. And once again, if you were to plot these graphically, you would see that these are parallel lines. That's why they have no solutions. They never intersect. There's no xy pair that satisfies both of these constraints. Let's do a couple more of these. When trying to find the solution to the following system of linear equations, Albus takes several correct steps that lead to the equation 5y is equal to negative 5. And they say, how many solutions does this system of linear equations have? Well, if 5y equals negative 5, we could divide both sides by 5, and we get y is equal to negative 1. And then if you substitute back in y is equal to negative 1, if you did it in this first equation, if y is equal to negative 1, all of this becomes positive 2. You can subtract 2 from both sides, and you get 5x is equal to 4. Or you'd get what? X is equal to 4 fifths. Or if you put negative 1 over here, you would get 5x minus 3 is equal to 1. You could add 3 to both sides, and you get 5x equals 4 again. X is equal to 4 fifths. So you have exactly one solution. You would have x is equal to 4 fifths. Y is equal to negative 1. Let's do one more. When trying to find the solution of the following system of linear equations, Levon takes several correct steps that lead to the equation 0 equals 0. So once again, I don't even need to look at this over here. 0 equals 0 is always going to be true. So this is going to have an infinitely many solutions.